Girl Next Door, Brainiac Vixen.
Hello.
Well done.
Thank you.
Well done.
It happens every time we go to a restaurant.
Yeah, you know, they just they see the Brainiac right there,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so should I call you doctor?
No, it's a far, far cry.
I don't want to give anything away,
you know,
with this, but let's talk about why people should go see it. All right, because I would think that would be the easiest thing to start with.
So we got up this morning. I think people should go see it if they want. I mean, it's what I go to see, what I go to theaters for. I mean, it's thrilling, it's hilarious, it's really, really witty, but it's got amazing, amazing monsters, amazing creativity and ambition, and it's just a thrill ride. And if you like blood or comedy or sex or, did I mention comedy,
you did.
Richard Jenkins or any of us or Bradley Whitford, I mean, it's got it all, and it's really adding a whole new turn onto a genre that's been done in terrific ways, but I mean, this is making its mark for sure.
Do I need to be a horror fan to enjoy this film?
Absolutely not.
No.
Absolutely not. I know a lot of people that are terrified and refuse to go to see horror films that have seen this and that love it.
I'm curious what the audition process was like, because my understanding, and you correct me if I'm wrong, that you didn't get an actual scene from the movie.
No.
No.
So tell me about that.
I think mine involved pterodactyls. I was getting chased by pterodactyls. It was a scene, it was Dana and Kurt, and like running away from pterodactyls. And I was reading it, and then there were some other scenes too, and I was like, geez, how are they gonna get all of this into one movie? This is crazy. And then I went to LA to have my audition with Joss and Drew, and the first thing Joss said was, you know what, these scenes aren't actually in the movie. And I was like, oh, okay, yeah.
You can take this pterodactyl suit off.
Yeah. Oh, cool, yeah. And then, you know, we got to read the actual script, and it was one of the most exciting scripts I had ever read. It's just when I thought it was going in one direction, it would go somewhere else, and they're just, by the end, it's just so shocking and so crazy that, I mean, I had no idea where it was going, and I think people are going to have a lot of fun with that.
I mean, the joke's on the audience, in a way. You know, you think about a horror film, and it's always us going, don't go in the woods, don't open that door.
Yeah.
But
that's you, it's like Aikido, that energy, like, let's take that energy and then turn it on itself.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I don't know that I read. I don't think I read the script till after we agreed to. I agreed to do the film. To be honest, I think one of the cool things about the audition process was it was kind of a classic New York. We were both from New York at the time. It's classic New York kind of LA experience. You go on tape from New York for an LA job. I went to my agent's office and like sat in an empty office, you know, trying to get like from next to the window and just doing it over and over again into the camera, and then getting brought out to LA to sit and read with those guys who were so excited and kind of added a whole new energy to that process. It's always better to do it live, but with these guys and there, you can tell just how you could feel the energy with them, and they're giving you notes and telling you that everything that you read was totally fake. I had all this crazy like locker room football field scene with Kurt, kind of like a homoerotic thing going on.
Of course,
it was good.
Maybe DVD extra.
Yeah, maybe.
You guys can do that.
Maybe. Didn't say we didn't shoot it. You know what I'm saying?
Anna, what was it like for you?
Oh, it was so cool. I was in Australia working on another show, and I just had my appendix out, so everything was kind of like crazy, and I did the audition, and then got a call back. And I was friends with Chris anyway, so he had said that he was in this film, and that was all exciting and stuff. And I was like, oh, I think I'm auditioning for that. Then anyway, the next day they said, can you do a retape and blah, blah, blah. And the job that I was at were like, no, you've got to come to set. And then I was like, but I've got to put this down just once. And then so I did it just the once, and then the car was there, I had to go to set. Thought, oh my gosh, I've really mucked that up. And then I didn't hear anything. And then Chris calls, and he's like, oh my God, babe, you got the job. And I'm like, but wait, I haven't even heard from my agent yet. So then I flew over to Vancouver, met the team, and just like,
I haven't even gotten the script yet.
I know. And then when I did finally get the script, as soon as I read it, I deleted it off my computer. Because I was like, shivers, what if like someone steals my computer or something like that? And then it goes, because
they were very intense about it.
Yeah,
I was going to say, everyone has done such a great job of keeping this under wraps. And and I feel like we really need to do that for the audience, because you just go and experience it.
Yeah.
You don't want to give anything away.
It would really be unfair, I think, to the audience to give too much away, because part of the fun is just taking that ride and being surprised and, not knowing where it's going
to
go.
That's a bit of a throwback, I think, too, which is what the film's trying to do. Like, to great films, you know, 30 years ago, we don't have all this exposure to the information age, to every review and everybody's Twitter comments. Like, just go see and experience it as it was intended to be. And that's what they set out to do. And, I mean, it speaks to their ambition. How are you nowadays trying to make a film where there's a huge secret at the end and think you're going to get away with it?
Yeah.
And we are, because the fans are supporting that.
Yeah. Well, congratulations, you guys.
Thanks.
I think you
so
knocked
much.
One out of the ballpark here.
Appreciate
thank
it,
you.
Trey. Thank you.
Very lucky.
All right.